And in this workshop, I will walk you through a model to quantify compliance risks. And in this session, I put my 22 experience in assessing and treating compliance risks, very important in public services, very public, important in many organizations, how we assess contractual risks in order to get the right pricing. And we also include here the risk of breaching the company policies, processes, and controls when in practice, employees and third parties need to comply with these requirements. But let me just explain something very important here about compliance. In compliance, if you are not having a supervisor ensuring that the employees are using the protection equipment, they will be the risk of a breach. They are based on the accountability principles that you need to implement some controls to reduce the chances for the organization to commit a criminal offense. For instance, to bribe a public officer or to have some fraud or to lose control or a piece of personal data of your customers. So this area is extremely, extremely important. For instance, privacy or controls or the auditors, in start talking about a data-driven risk assessment based on quantified goals for the operations and the requirements that we need to set. There are plenty of very immature practices, which have a good opportunity for us as a risk manager. There are plenty of low-hanging fruits that can be easily achieved by setting tasks, by setting a big model to define non-compliances. So look for the non-compliances. They should be valued. They should have a priority in this report for years. This information is collected. There are industry reports in the banking sector, for instance. All the operational risks are reported and shared. And you can also look for non-compliances by competitors or in a country, which are the hot topics, how the enforcement is evolving. You can also help them to calculate the right level of pricing in concession bids, contracts. Also, here, there is a lot of risk financing. I say don't go in this due diligence or don't go in due diligence. But remember, in this area, it's very important that you keep in mind that you need to sell stories. You need to sell this decision-making because usually the people in the business are just seeing the output and they are not used to our quantitative techniques. So, in general, you need to measure the risk of non-compliance in the contractual clauses. You need to start from the contractual requirements, clause by clause, and assess that the compliance and legal assumptions that you are thinking is going to happen when you are deciding to sign this contract, to offer that contract in a service, if you are expecting me to say heat maps in this forum is not going to fly. You need to consider a calculation for setting penalties and indemnizations, finance sanctions, and legal and remediation costs. Always, 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 you're going to have immediate consequences of the non-compliance, and they are very easily calculated because they are set in a contract, in a law, in a regulation. So if you are able to understand or to foresee how many clients will decline a service, and then you can see how much of the marketing investment was lost because there is a scandal, a reputation issue, you are not meeting the expectations, it's moved to the standard error, and then you have a formula. I wrote it down in as an Excel formula that I think helps in order to copy and paste this formula. In my previous workshop in the Risk Awareness Week, I gave a tool in order to understand how Monte Carlo was working with, and here is the natural evolution of that initial approach, in which you can have a formula that you can copy and paste and use to your models as long as you are talking about a log normal distribution, that they can be used for impacts and probabilities. You got the details about the different workshops, and you can find the link to this model to download, play, vandalize, really test this model, and I am more than welcome to support any thought and any improvement. It's just this formula that is a natural evolution of my previous session last year. And then you have also a probability, because we are not so optimistic, so it's going to be higher, or you want to be in the 50%. You also have some cases, but then you have a maximum and a minimum amount. So definitely it's going to be much lower.